I have walked the dirt roads of Uganda.
I walked the dirt roads of Uganda. I see the scars that war has left behind. Hope like the sun is fading. They're waiting for a cure no one can find. And I hear children's voices singing of a God who heals and rescues and restores. And I'm reminded that every child in Africa is yours. And it's all yours, God.
There's an old proverb that says, give a man a fish and you feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish, and you feed him for a lifetime.
Everybody falls sometimes. Gotta find the strength.
Providing the means for someone to make a difference in their life is the basis behind microfinance. Microfinance is the provision of credit to low-income consumers who traditionally lack access to banking service. In quoting Mohamed Yunus, microfinance is based on the premise that the poor have skills which remain unutilized or underutilized. It is definitely not the lack of skills which make poor people poor. Charity is not the answer to poverty. It only helps poverty to continue. It creates dependency and takes away the individual's initiative to break through the wall of poverty. Unleashing of energy and creativity in each human being is the answer to poverty. Microfinance allows the poor to protect, diversify, and increase their sources of income. Microfinance gives people more options, empowering them to make their own choices and build their own way out of poverty. The goal of this advocacy plan is to create a women's cooperative group in Gulu, Uganda, and then raise the necessary capital so that these women will be able to access microfinance loans. This microcredit will enable individuals to begin businesses to support their families. The cooperative will initially be comprised of 18 to 20 women of the Layibi region of Gulu, Uganda, and will be led by Margaret Lagulu and Christine Lalam. They are part of the leadership of the United Methodist Church in Gulu, and they are well respected in their community. They have the social collateral necessary to provide the credibility to the group. Empowering the women at the Layibi Women's Cooperative through microfinance loans will give these women the opportunity to be defined by dignity, not poverty. In order to provide the initial capital of $20,000 for the loans, we need the support of your United Methodist Women's Group. Your goals of developing leaders and advocating for justice align with the objectives of the Layibi Women's Cooperative, and therefore this seems like a great partnership. These loans will have the ability to rebuild communities, to restore dignity, and to transform lives. With training and a loan as small as $50, women can start businesses, provide for their families, and bring hope to their communities.
Sometimes you will have the strength to rise.